And welcome to another episode of FooBar. It's a new year! Happy 2023! After the celebrations and the fireworks are done, we finish visiting our parents, our friends, and the hangovers start going away, we start thinking. At least I always do, and I see Twitter, I know you do too. We start thinking about what we want to accomplish during the new year. That's why this is the first video of the year. If you watch my channel, you're a serverless fan and you're here for your first year accomplishment. New Year's is all about resolutions, and what best resolution than a new certification? In today's video, we are going to talk about Serverless Badge. It's a new type of certification. Certifications are a great way to prove your knowledge and to make sure that everybody knows that you know. Did you know that last reInvent in 2022, in December, we announced a new serverless certificate? I know it's not a specialty certification, but it's a new way to prove your serverless knowledge. It's a serverless badge that you can attach to your social media, your resume, whatever you like. And how you get this badge? Well, you can watch this video and I will show it to you, but at the end of the day, you need to answer some questions and prove your knowledge. The badge is issued by Credly, that is a certification authority, so it's a valid certification with all these things that come around the certification, so you can prove your validity and all these kind of things. But yeah, let's go and check how I got my certification. I already did, and I will show you what you can expect, what you need to know, and all those things. So the first thing you need to know is to go to the serverless learning plan. I will leave you the link in the description box. And in here, you can basically find all the information to get started with serverless. So this is the training and certification website that will provide the serverless learning plan. This badge is attached to the learning plan. So if you are like, well, I might not know enough about serverless yet in order to pass this certificate, don't worry. The learning plan is free and it will guide you through all the process. And also you have my channel that is also free and has all the material that you need. There you can also find this ramp up guide. This is awesome. And this ramp up guide is a PDF that you can take, and it has links to different learnings. Luckily my channel is not there, but you can find a lot of official AWS resources there that you can explore. Everything is in different rows, so there is a lots of material for you to go. And then if you go through the learning plan, everything will be there. So let's start with the learning plan and see what happens. So this opens. The first thing you need to do is you can explore this page. And you can check, there is a couple of languages available. I know there is no Spanish, but well, I hope in the future. This is quite new. And there you can read everything that is there, and you can go to learning plan structure. There you will find all the different courses. Some of them are in Spanish and in other languages as well. And you can take those courses. Those courses are awesome. They go through a lot of information, and these are the official AWS courses, so you can go and check them up. And at the end, you can see there the learning plan badge assessment. So you need to complete that one to get the badge. So the first thing you do is to enroll. You need to be registered with a valid email and do all those things. I already have an account, so I will go and start learning now. And you can start your learning plan. It's a long thing, so take your time. It's a new resolution, so you don't need to rush through it. But if you're brave and you've been following this YouTube channel for long enough, you can go directly to the badge assessment. And you can take that assessment without taking the learning plan. That's not mandatory. That's what I did. I didn't went through all the learning plan. I just went and started doing the assessment. So these are the requirements. You have to pass it 80% of the 50 questions. So you have 50 questions, you have to complete 80% correctly. There is no time limit, and you can attempt it once. You can attempt it again if you fail it, but you need to wait. And Yes, you can save the progress and continue later, because the questions are like AWS certification questions. They are long, there's a lot of text, there are multiple choice, so you need to think. The answer is not like numeric data in most of the cases, it's just four problems. So it will ask you, you have this scenario with an e-commerce and blah, 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 they have this problem, what is the best solution? And it shows you like four different options that can be the best solution. And it makes you think. The test covered very in-depth Lambda and API gateway and also event-driven applications. So if you are familiar with these three things, then you are fine. Then it goes into observability, networking, and things like that related to those topics. So that's something you need to polish. If you know me, I'm very weak on my BPC parts and I failed them. But luckily I passed the exam on my first try. So I took the test. And you can basically begin the test. I will not show you the questions. You can just go and try it yourself. And then after you get it, you will get the badge. So I will go and do the test and I see you when I'm done. So yes, I passed the test. Woohoo! 87% on my first go. And if you go after you finish the test, you will see the answers. You can analyze what answers you got wrong. You can see what happened. And all that information is there available for you. So you should go and check that one out. And then in a few days, you will receive an email to the email that you register for from Credly with your badge. And there you can create an account if you don't have from Credly. And there you will be able to share that badge in your social network. You will be able to attach it to your LinkedIn profile. You can download it and put it in your resume. I already did that. So if you want to see how my profile looks, you can go to my LinkedIn and see it there. It's available and you can find me in LinkedIn with my name. So do you have a New Year's resolution now? I hope so. And with that, that's the video for me today. Now we are starting with the launches from reInvent from the last year, so stay tuned for everything that is coming. I have a lot of videos on the serverless launches. It was a very good year for us, so stay tuned. And I leave you here two playlists, one for Lambda that you need to know a lot in order to pass this certification, and one for event-driven architectures that is the other thing that you need to understand in order to pass this certification. And I see you in another episode of FooBar. Ciao, ciao!